In this tutorial, I'll be teaching you all you need to know about word embedding and also teach you how to embed your textual data for your next natural language processing project. We'll be using PyTorch, which happens to be one of the greatest deep learning framework in this particular tutorial. To start off, what is word embedding? So word embedding refers to the representation of words as dense vectors in a high dimensional space. So the main reason why word embedding are very important is that they capture the semantic and synthetic relationship between words, allowing machines to also understand and analyze natural language. We'll be using GloVe for this particular tutorial. And if you're asking what is GloVe, GloVe just stands for Global Vectors for Word Representation. GloVe is actually an unsupervised learning algorithm for obtaining word embeddings. Okay, so now with the theory out of the way, let's get into coding and see how we can implement word embedding in PyTorch. To start off, you need to install some couple of libraries. You need to install TorchTest. Also, you need to install Torch. And I'll make sure the code together with these requirements will be on my GitHub repository where you guys can leverage and use it in your own project. So all you need to do is to do pip install requirement.txt and you'll get these two libraries installed. I've already installed this library, so I'm not going to install it again. So I'll start off by importing the libraries. So from torchtest.data.utils, we are going to import get tokenizer. Also from torchtest.vocab, we are going to import glove. We also import torch as well, so we just have to write import torch. And these are all the libraries or dependencies we need in this particular tutorial. In order to convert textual data into embeddings or word embeddings, you need to tokenize them. So in my previous tutorial, I taught you how to perform tokenization using the PyTorch framework. That video is only about 5 to 6 minutes long, so you can check it out, and the link will also be in the description. So I'll quickly jump into tokenizing this word, since I already have a tutorial on that you guys can watch, but I also make sure I explain it right here so that you will understand. So first, we need a text, so we can just write text is equal to any text at all. So we can say, okay, this is my first word embedding project. We'll begin with this text. So I said earlier on, the first approach is to tokenize this text. So we just have to initialize our tokenizer because we are importing it right here. So I can just call this tokenizer, and this will be equal to get tokenizer, and that's it. So inside here, we just have to specify that you are using basic English to perform your tokenization. And all you need to tokenize this word is just call your tokenizer and you pass in your test. So this will go ahead and tokenize this test for you. And text which have been tokenized are in tokens. So we just take this as tokens. So tokens is equal to whatever we are getting back. And I will go ahead and print the tokens so that we can see whatever it is on the terminal. And here we go. So you can see it has retained this as a list, and our words have been tokenized successfully. If you really care about understanding tokenization in depth, you can watch my previous tutorial on tokenization using PyTorch framework. Okay, so this is how easy we can tokenize our words. And then once we are getting the tokens here, we can just pass these tokens now into GloVe in order to return to us our word embeddings. So we also create a GloVe object here, which is equal to GloVe. And over here, we need to pass in some couple of things. So we'll pass in the name, and this will be the name of the particular pre-trained model we want to use. So we are going to use SysB. We are using the particular pre-trained model with the 6 billion parameters. And also we'll pass in our dimension as 100. Now that we've initialized this, we can go ahead and get our indices. from our tokens by just writing indices, and this is equal to perform some list comprehension right here so that we can look through all our tokens and convert them. So we say glove dot stoi, which means string to index. So we are converting all the tokens from string to index, and this will take token and we say okay for token in our token. So all we are doing is that we are looping through all these tokens that our tokenizer will return, and for each token we are converting it to an index. So we are using the stoi string to index function here to convert them. Now right after converting them, we can convert these indices to word embeddings, or let's first print these indices and see how they look like. And guys, we got an error saying key error embedding. Oh, okay, so I guess it has to do with the spelling of embedding is wrong. So this is actually not in the GloVe pre-trained model, this word, because the word is wrongly spelled. So what I'll do is that I'll just come here and change the spelling. I think it should be only one B, embedding, and the D should be two. So I'll run this once again, and here we go. So these are the indices for all our tokens. So this, the first line here is our tokens, and these are the indices. Okay, so the last thing we have to do here is to convert these indices to embeddings, and this is also pretty much easy to do. For that, we'll store this in embeddings, and this is equal to our glove dot vectors, and then inside here we'll convert everything to touch. Tensor, and that's all. So we can just go ahead and print our embeddings and see how they look. So let me run this, and with a little bit of luck, I hope there will be no errors. Okay, here we go, guys. So you can see these are the embeddings. So you can see how long the embeddings are for this particular short text we are using. First, we convert the text to tokens, then we convert them to get their indices, and then we went further ahead to convert these indices to embeddings. You can see how long these particular embeddings are. We can actually also print the shape to see the shape of it. So print embeddings, check how the shape looks like. Okay, so you can see it's 7 by 100. Guys, this is pretty much it. This is how you can take test, you tokenize it, convert it to an embedding, and from here you can use this test to now train your model, because it's in a numeric form. You can't use actually string or test data to train a model. You have to convert them to tokens, then from tokens you need to convert them to embeddings. If you enjoy these PyTorch tutorials, let me know in the comment section, and also don't forget to subscribe, like, and as usual, I will see you in an upcoming tutorial. Thanks for watching.